Hey all, my name is Paul Borosky and I am the owner of Quality Business Plan, and what I'd like to do today is give you all some tips and tricks on how to write a craft brewery business plan. So without further ado, let's go ahead and let's mosey on through this little process. I got a PowerPoint presentation packed with fun and exciting information about your craft brewery business plan. All right, so before we get into that little PowerPoint presentation, a little bit about me, then we're going to talk about you, talk about your craft brewery business plan. For me, I am a professional writer, specifically a business writer and business plan writer. I've published many books on Amazon. I've done many, even more, ghostwriting projects, and also I love to write business plans. So if y'all want to avoid the fun and excitement of writing your own business plan, pick up the phone, give me a call, send me a text, send me an email. I would be absolutely delighted to write your business plan for you. If you do want to go down the business plan writing path yourself, please use me as a guide. Again, you can pick up my books on Amazon.com. Scroll over to Amazon.com, type in my name, Paul Borosky, and voila, you'll have a whole bunch of books about business plan writing at your fingertips. And finally, why I am qualified to be able to give you these tips and tricks for writing your own business plan. I am an adjunct expert. I'm an adjunct professor for finance and for business. So not only do I do business plans, but I also do financial models. So if you need some financial projections for your up and coming craft brewery business plan, again, give me a shout. Love to help. All right, enough about me. Let's talk about you. Let's talk about your company. Let's talk about your craft brewery business plan. So tip number one, in your company description, a good place to start is going to be your competitive advantages. So when you're doing your competitive advantages, make sure to highlight, you know, how you're going to gain market share. So a competitive advantage is going to talk about how you're going to gain market share, whether it's going to be because your location is prime, it's going to be because your craft brews itself, or it can be about the complementing brewers, national brewers or regional brewers that you're going to be serving in conjunction with your craft brews. A better strategy in the competitive advantage section is to identify a core competency in your company. So core competency is what you do better than everybody else, and it's hard to duplicate by your competitors. So you might have a strong brewing process in your craft brewery, and you know, and from that brewing process, you make better brews than everybody else, or it's more efficient, or you know, it's a higher quality, or it's got better taste. But something, make sure to identify, if you can identify a core competency, make sure to include that in your competitive advantages section. However, the best strategy when doing your competitive advantage section is to identify a distinctive competence. A distinctive competence is something that is unique to your organization. You do it better because nobody else does it. And that might be, you know, for an example, for a craft brewery, is you might, your best taste in beer might have the lowest calories. That's something that nobody else can do. So try to identify a distinctive competence for your competitive advantages. If not, then go for a core competency. However, worst case scenario, if you can't identify a distinctive competence or a core competency, then go with your competitive advantage and talk about your location, you know, what's going to help you gain market share. All right, next, tip number two is research your industry. A lot of craft brewery business owners from my discussions and writing business plans, I have found that a lot of craft brewery business owners, they like to tell me about their competitors, and they can tell me all about their competitors, from, you know, the clarity of their beer to the quality of taste to their prices, and they just, you know, they go on and on and on about the local competition, which is fantastic. You definitely want to know your competitors. However, what I find for a lot of businesses in general, and also for a craft brewery, is that I would start my industry research at a national level. I would go and I would start reading some of these craft brewery magazines. There's plenty of them out there. Join one of the craft brewery associations and start talking to other craft brewers across the US. When you're in these discussions, when you're doing your research, identify what are some of the trends that are happening in the industry. What are some of the things that our customers are demanding from craft breweries? Once you identify the statistics and the trends that are going on, then what you can do is you can go into your local area. Now you can start researching competitors and look for traits in the competitors that are aligned with national trends. Once you identify those few competitors that are embracing national trends, then you know who to focus on, who to do in-depth research on, and then how to create business models to best create, best compete with those few individuals or competition that is aligned with industry trends. So tip number three, advertising. From a lot of discussions with craft brewery owners and entrepreneurs seeking to get into the craft brewery, what I have found is they do a great job with the social media and they do a great job with the word of mouth advertising. But the one aspect of advertising that unfortunately goes a little bit to the wayside is going to be their websites. Some craft brewery owners, what they've been doing is they've been utilizing Facebook in lieu of a website. When you do that, you're hurting your Google rankings, you're hurting your Bing rankings, because you know approximately 25% of all people that go out for dining or for entertainment, they are Googling that information to see, you know, if there's any, you know, new places that are out, or you know, if they're going to a new area, you know, what are some of the reviews for those other entities. So make sure you have a website, make sure that website is up to date and it's engaging. And when you do that, then you're going to be capturing that. You're going to have an increased likelihood of capturing that 25% of people that go straight to Google or straight to Bing or straight to Yahoo for their internet search as compared to a Facebook website. And next is going to be tip number four, funding request, a little bit of money. Interestingly enough, as I'm sure craft brewery organizations know, funding is not cheap to start a craft brewery. You've got to buy the equipment to brew the beers. You've got to still buy your tables and your chairs and your bar stools, and you still have to, you know, have a nice bar set up. You still have to get your decor and do all your build out. So you've got a lot of information. You've got a lot of money that you're going to have to spend in order to get your craft brewery up and running. So when you're structuring your funding request, you'll follow a specific proven format. First and foremost, in the first two sentences of your funding request document, make sure to put an explicit dollar amount that you need in order to start operations. Stay away from the ranges. Don't say $40,000 to $80,000 or $300,000 to $400,000. When you start using ranges, it kind of shows that you have really no idea how much money you need to start your organization. And that's not the ambiance or the image that you want to go ahead and present to the first reader of your document. So stay away from the ranges. Use a specific dollar amount in your first two sentences. Next, follow up that section with a breakdown in categories of how much money you're going to need. You know, for example, how much is it going to be for your, you know, build out for your location? How much is it going to be for the brewery machineries? How much is it going to be for your tables and chairs? How much money do you need for working capital? Make sure you put those categories, and no need to provide too many details. We don't need to know if you're doing inventory, how many pieces of hops that you're going to have measured in ounce and then broken down to a dollar figure. You don't need that. Too much information often leads to confusions, especially when you're doing finance. Keep it simple. It's the best strategy. So make sure you break down your categories. Make sure you break down your funding request in the categories. At the end of the categories, then total up all the categories and show a total dollar amount. That total dollar amount should be identical to the top line dollar amount that you put in the first two sentences. All right, tip number five, a little bit of money. Everybody starts a business to make money. In order to make money, we've got to be able to do some kind of projections to figure out what our costs are going to be, what our anticipated revenues are going to be, and if we need additional money in the future. So what I've got right here is just a three-step, really basic financial projection to help you see whether a specific month is going to give you a profit or a loss and how much. So the way that I've broken down this craft brewery revenue section is as follows. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to identify on average how many different beers we're going to sell on a daily basis. So we're going to break it into craft brews, we're going to break it into national beers, and then we're going to break it into food items if we're going to be selling some food. Next thing we need to do is identify what our sales price is going to be and a variable cost. Once we're done with that, we're going to subtract our variable cost from our prices. It's going to give us our gross profits. From that point, we're then going to multiply our gross profits by the number of craft brews we're going to sell, multiply the gross profits by the number of national beers we think we're going to sell on a daily basis, and so on. Once we're done with that, we're going to then total it up, and that's going to give us our gross total gross profits, which is right here. This is on a daily basis. We are then going to multiply that by the number of days that we're going to be open every month, and it's going to give us our gross monthly profits. In this example, it's going to be $41,242.50. We are then going to drop this number way down here to step three. It's going to be our top line. Step number two is we're going to do our monthly fixed cost. We're going to have loans. We're going to have to buy inventory. We're going to have to pay our people. You know, imagine that. We're going to have space rental. We're going to have utilities and marketing and legal and the miscellaneous. Always a miscellaneous. There's no way you're going to be able to come up with every single penny of how much you're going to be dropping on a monthly basis. So always have a miscellaneous section. Once you all identify all that information, then total it up right here, and that's going to be your total monthly cost. Once that's done, then you're going to bring this number down to step number three, and you're going to place it right here in the monthly cost. Once we're done with step number two, we're going to go down to step number three, and step number three is pretty much already done because we dropped down our monthly profits here. We dropped down our monthly fixed cost here. All we got to do now is subtract our monthly cost from our monthly gross profits, which gives us a net profit of $13,142.50. All right, so the beautiful thing about having this kind of structure is not only do we know what our net profit is going to be for this specific month, but we now have a financial model where we can go ahead and start tweaking and changing items. And as we're tweaking and changing items, our financial model is going to be updated accordingly. So for example, if we want to bump up our craft brewery, we can change the sales price from $650 to $750. And once we do that, all the numbers are going to change, and it's going to show us what happens to our net profits. We can do the same thing for monthly cost. If we think our labor is going to be a little bit more expensive, we bump up that number there. And again, it shows us immediately what's going to happen to our net profits. A handy dandy little tool to be using, not only when you're writing your craft brewery business plan, but just for operations in general. And in summary, follow a proven format. Your craft brewery business plan is not going to follow the same structure as a manufacturer, as a retail seller, as an online, shoe salesperson. It's going to be different. It's going to have different components, and it's going to have different highlights and so on. So make sure when you're doing your business plan, follow a structure that is aligned with your craft brewery. If you can't find one, contact me. I'd be delighted to go ahead and provide one for you. Next is going to be keep the star of the show as the business. Yes, you're going to do a lot of wonderful things, and you're going to be, quenching people's thirst, and there's no other brewery company within a 50-mile radius. And also for the business owners might have, owned 15 other restaurants, and they've been brewing since they were seven. But just keep in mind, we want to keep the star of the show the business, the internal environment and the external environment. We don't want to just, go crazy about all the benefits that this company is going to bring to the community. And we also don't want to just, talk about how great the owner is. We want to have a well-balanced business business plan, you're going to have a certain amount of information talking about the product, certain amount of information talking about the location, a certain amount of information talking about your target market, certain amount of information talking about your industry. Keep it well balanced and keep the star of the show as the business. And finally, if you all need some help with writing the business plan, doing your financial models, please do not hesitate to give me a call, send me an email. I would be absolutely delighted to assist y'all in writing your craft brewery business plan. And if y'all do want to go ahead and mosey on down that path, like I said, of writing your own craft brewery business plan, and you do want some more information, please go ahead and head on over to my website. It is qualitybusinessplan.com/how-to-write-a-craft-brewery-business-plan. So when you go ahead and write that, once you go ahead and visit this website here, I do give you all some more tips and tricks on how to write a craft brewery business plan. And finally, if y'all really want a lot of information on writing your own business plan, again, go over to my website, go over to my webpage on Amazon, amazon.com/author/Paul Borosky. And once you get there, you're going to have all kinds of wonderful business plan writing books at your fingertips. So hopefully this little video was helpful. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up, and also please follow me. And if y'all need some help with a plan, just like I said, pick up the phone, give me a call. Love to help. Thank you very much.